One of the challenges facing leaders is that despite their efforts to elevate empathy within the organization, team members don't always feel it on the ground floor. And this disconnect occurs for various reasons. But one of those reasons can be that empathy sometimes can feel a little bit like a fuzzy, touchy, feely kind of concept. And this is usually down to a lack of understanding of what it actually means to be an empathetic organization. Being an empathetic organization or an empathetic leader doesn't mean that we have to give everybody hugs all the time, or that we have to give in to everybody's wants and whims, or that we can't give honest feedback. When leaders show empathy, people feel safe. They tend to take more risks, be more creative, engaged, and inclusive. In addition to empathy being perceived by some as fuzzy, leaders may lack empathy due to various other reasons, such as the organizational structures or systems which prevent or perhaps don't reward empathetic behavior. Some people just turn up for work and they don't have passion or belief in the work that they do. They're not engaged, and empathy actually requires an investment of time and energy. And so some people may just not be motivated to give that time and energy. Also, there's a kind of biological reason. The neural pathways that we use to think about other people are the same neural pathways we use to think about ourselves. Now, leaders tend to spend time focusing on results, share prices, and spend very little time thinking about themselves. Therefore, the neural pathway that actually thinks our empathy, if you like, neural pathway, the neural pathways that we use when we're thinking about ourselves and other people, tend to be not terribly well developed. They have a high electrical resistance, meaning that it's really draining on the individual's energy. So, as the brain is wired for survival and energy conservation is actually part of that, then they're less likely to use the neural circuitry, making it harder to think about people. And it's that old adage of people focus versus task focus. There's also a link between being in a position of power and empathy. Some research done by Michael Krauss at Yale found that people who were less privileged, poor, or lonely tended to be more empathetic. And this was because of their survival instinct of needing other people. But as people rise in power, often they feel they have everything and they don't really need others, so they don't have the same motivation to be empathetic. This is not to say that they cannot be empathetic. It's about awareness and finding a way past those motivational barriers that can get in the way of that empathetic connection. The fifth reason why a leader may lack empathy can be explained by way of behavioural preferences. Some behavioural preferences lend themselves to higher levels of empathy. For example, people who have a thinking preference, who focus on facts, figures, strategies, and results, will have to work hard to show empathy in comparison to an individual who has a feeling preference. When we start to explore thinking versus feeling preferences and empathy, we can start to see some of the reasons why leaders who have higher levels of self-awareness tend to have higher levels of empathy. An individual with a thinking preference may find it quite hard to express their feelings and vulnerabilities, whereas a feeling person may not express their vulnerability because they don't want to burden the other person. They just want to help. A person with a feeling preference will tend to have a higher level of motivation, that empathetic concern I spoke about earlier. Whereas a person with a thinking preference may increase the range of their empathetic concern by reframing empathy for others as a way to help the individual grow and perform, which in turn will get the result or outcome. What they are doing is driving that feeling action with a thinking motivation. We've already said that empathy isn't fixed. We all have an empathy range, and with practice, we can develop and increase our range. By being self-aware and understanding our behavioral preferences, it helps us to identify development areas that we might wish to focus on to increase our empathetic range. So, for example, a person with a thinking preference may consider working on their curiosity and widening their circle of contacts, whereas a person with a feeling preference may be more prone to emotional exhaustion and burnout if they're not aware of a tendency to get emotionally involved. So they may need to practice letting go and be more objective. Leaders must know who they are, their strengths, their preferences, their passions, and areas of development, as these are the foundations of empathy and success. Behavioral profiling tools such as Jigsaw Discovery will provide insight into your preferences, your range of empathy. It will help you to foster opportunities to adapt your thinking and behavior to be more productive and appreciate your motivators' strengths and judgmental area and development areas. Jigsaw Discovery can provide insights into how others see you and help you understand their feelings and preferences. And leaders who have those higher levels of self-awareness and understanding of others tend to have increased range of empathy and be seen by others as empathetic.